Yeah, good evening everybody. A very, very warm welcome to Suzanne's big night out. I was saying that she's really, really, really been looking forward to this, and is just so thrilled to have everybody here in the room that she knows and loves. She's asked me to help with proceedings. I'm Andrea, by the way. And I do feel a bit of a fraud, actually, having the microphone, because I know there's probably so many of you in this room who has known Suzanne a lot longer than I have, and we'd have brilliant stories to tell. But you know, you can always come up at any point in the night and share all your stories with us. I met Suzanne just a couple of years ago when I went to interview her for STV's Real Heroes. I can't believe she didn't win that. I mean, did you see her on TV? She was amazing, wasn't she? And I met Suzanne and her amazing family that day, and you know, I'm a reporter at STV, and I have met and talked to so many people over the years, but there are very, very few people, and I'm not just saying this, that have moved me and inspired me in the way that Suzanne did. And she just absolutely, like, stole my heart with her story, but just more than that, her attitude and her positivity against adversity. And so we became firm friends, and she hasn't got rid of me since, so that's why I'm here tonight. And I think everybody will agree that she is one in a million. And we're all extremely, extremely glad and happy to call you our friend. We know that you've been through the most dreadful time, you and your family. But I think what we'll all agree on is that Suzanne doesn't let that define her, but I think it's definitely shaped you into the person that you've become today. Strong, positive, and determined to squeeze every last ounce out of life. So, without further ado, before I hand you over to her, I think we need to start the night with a big happy birthday, so let's sing.
Happy birthday to you.
Everyone here tonight. Andrea, thank you so much. So much for supporting me and agreeing to be my MC for tonight. You're a true friend, just as you said. So please make sure you enjoy the night as well. Don't let your hair down, okay? First of all, I didn't do these decorations, by the way. I wasn't allowed to come yet.
Talk about
interest, please, will you? Oh, that way.
Yeah.
Sorry. Just to confirm, I was saying that I didn't do these decorations. This was done in the last hour before I was allowed to come along. So, God, there is something else. As I say, welcome to everyone. And thank you for my family, mainly, and my friends for arranging this and setting it all up. It's wonderful. I'm blown away with how many of my family and friends are actually here tonight. You've made the effort to come along and support me. And tonight is all about celebration and fun too. As you'll all know, for those that haven't heard the full story, but we'll go on forever, because you've all heard it a million times. I was diagnosed with a grade 4 brain tumour 4 years ago. I underwent surgery, whilst awake, to remove as much of the tumour as possible. 3 weeks later, whilst expecting to be told about my treatment plan, myself, my family and I were told in a very brutal way that whilst most of the tumour had been removed during surgery, what was left would never be gone. It was the highest grade of brain tumour that you could have. I'm reading all this like I don't know it, but we all know I've got a bad short term memory, so this is just it. My consultant told me that day that if I had no treatment, I'd have a year to live, and if I had chemo, I'd have 8 weeks more. bam, straight in our heads, in our faces. It hit us like a bus. Especially as Max and Lauren were only 7 and 4 at the time. As you'll all know, I'm a very positive and determined bugger. I was not going to let this tumour take my life. I just need to look at the kids. Where are you guys? Max will kill me for asking that. See ya. I just need to look at the kids to keep me going. I'd also done some personal growth before I was diagnosed, which helped my positivity massively. Following my prognosis, I underwent chemotherapy and radiotherapy. I was told that the best result we would get would be stable. At that time, I thought, stable? Is that seriously the best it's ever going to be the rest of my life? I receive MRI scans every 6 months now to check that my tumour hasn't grown, but we know it'll never be gone. But it's funny these days how stable is celebrated. You know, woo! You know, particularly at the start, that was a big thing, and now it's like, it's stable every single time. So it's wonderful. Post-surgery and treatment, I do have some issues such as bad fatigue, a right pituitary gland, early menopause, and a thyroid condition. Things that aren't visible but cause me problems. Poor Owen has to deal with our hormones though. Poor guy. I'm not made of steel and I do have my moments, but on the whole, from day one, I decided that I could sit in the corner and cry about it, but it wouldn't help, so I would just get up and get on with it instead. At the time of diagnosis, I was 36 and kept saying that if I turn 40, if, I'll be having a huge party. Well, here we are now, 3 days later. During these 4 years, I've had so much support from my rock of a husband, Owen. Seriously strong kids. We're now 11 and 8, and are here tonight. I won't stand up, so I better not ask my time. My amazing parents, Mo and Keith. The people that are here tonight and that are invited, obviously, are the ones that are always asking how I'm doing and supporting me, and that means so much. I'm over the moon to be Auntie Sue's to Megan and our new niece or nephew who is coming next month. So, for God's sake, do not go and leave her tonight, please. When I was first diagnosed, we looked into as much information on cancer as we could. Being fortunate in never having cancer in the family, we naively thought that the Cancer Research UK charity covered funding for all types of cancer, but less than 2% of the funding goes to brain tumours. Crazy. In 2015, many of you wonderful people helped me to raise an incredible £42,000 for the brain tumour charity, who helped in research for a cure for brain tumours. So the other part of tonight, as you all know, but I'll just explain it. I decided a long time ago that I wanted to raise as much money as possible for Clan. Come in. I wanted to raise as much money for the Clan charity. Clan stands for Cancer Link, Aberdeen and North East, North. They were the place that we all rushed to on that day of my short prognosis, and I don't know what we would have done without them. Since then, not only have they listened to us, but have also provided counselling service to Lauren last year to help her understand things. She was so young when everything happened that she started to realise now actually what's going on and you know what's happening to Mum. So they actually brought a counselling service to the school, which is wonderful. So it's a place she knows, but it's not a new person in a new place. And they were just wonderful. Clan also provided free complementary treatments for cancer patients and their families, and they're wonderful. Last year I decided that I enjoyed the reflexology treatments so much that I wanted to become a reflexologist. The course was much harder than I expected, with not only learning the procedure and also exams and essays, especially with a shockingly bad term, bad short-term memory, but I did it, and I passed with a merit. I also went on to study Indian head massage and passed that too. So I now finally know what I want to do with my life, and that's to help others. I can only treat one person per day due to fatigue, but if I can help one person per day, it's worth it. Right, I think that's enough of my voice, but thank you all for once again for coming along and supporting me and everything that you've donated and the presents and the cards are amazing. A special mention again to my wonderful family and those who have travelled from England, Glasgow and Edinburgh to be here tonight, including, Gemma, I am going to make you stand up, including my incredible friend Gemma, who has the same tumour as I do, but please Gemma, stand up.
Aww.
She's going to embarrass you. Gemma's got the same kind of tumour as I do, and she's about 6 months behind me, still here, but sadly, and the same as we all do, but Gemma had said, you know, at the start, thank goodness it's me and not the kids. Well, sadly, a few months later, Gemma's son, Noah, at age 3, was also diagnosed with a brain tumour in his eye. Just months after Gemma was diagnosed herself, as I say, they've had the treatment, he's had a surgery, and he's doing amazingly well, and I just put my heart just goes out to them. They've just got dealt with so much, and her, Gemma and her mum, Barb, have come up today from London for the day and one night just to be here tonight, and I'm just so grateful. Gemma, you're an absolute marvel. Finally, thank you for all the lifts when I wasn't allowed to drive despite never having had a seizure. You all know what that means to me, driving, since I've been 3 years old. Probably the ages on that. Can't let it. We've already been fortunate to have some lovely gifts donated to us for our raffle auction. Many thanks to you all for all those and who have helped us to get to this stage, helping me to make tonight happen. Pittodrie and the staff at Sodexo have been a joy to work with, and thanks to you too. The room looks amazing tonight. If anyone's into football and wants to have a nose, there's one of the boxes open just now. Surely we'll begin with a game called Heads and Tails, which we'll explain to you, but will be fun. In a moment, for anyone that knows Owen, this won't be easy, and I didn't ask him to do it, but Owen wants to say a few words. I'm glad he spoke for him, because I think I may be upset. I don't know what he's going to say, as I say, but I must say thank you. Meantime, please join me in having an epic time. Meantime, just enjoy me and have an epic night and raising as much money for Clan as humanly possible. Thank you very much.
Thanks everyone here for coming along tonight. Thanks for supporting Suze, supporting Clan, and I hope you all have a lot of fun. Your generosity tonight means a lot to all of the family, and it's much appreciated, I can assure you. I just wanted to say some words about the birthday girl. Most people think that reaching 40 is a bit depressing, but for us, it's a major celebration. As you can imagine, the last few years have been very difficult. Take it from me, Suzanne, you've dealt with a lot.
Go!
In the face of some tough times, she showed incredible courage and real resilience. Her positivity, her determination inspire everyone around her, and that certainly includes me. She is one determined woman, and do I know it. She's a great mum to our lovely kids, a great wife to me, and I had absolutely no doubt we would all be here celebrating her 40th. Just as I have no doubt we will be celebrating many more birthdays.
Yes.
Suzanne, I am so proud of you, and I really want you to have a great night. Have a great night. You more than deserve it. Happy birthday.
You'll see on your tables there are some envelopes, and that's for the heads and tails game, which we'll be playing shortly. If you want to play, it's not easy, but if you want to play, if you can please maybe put in £5 per person, or £10 a couple, if that's easier. And also, Kelly will be pretty much situated all night in this chair. I think she's deserves it. And she's going to be selling raffle tickets. There's some amazing prizes. You can come down and have a look at the table. It's going to be £5 a strip. So please come and see Kelly, buy your raffle tickets, and if you want to play heads and tails, please put money in the envelopes and we'll come round and collect them from the tables. And we will be playing that quite soon. So have a great night. Thank you.